Welcome. In this video, I'm going to use the BA2+ calculator to solve this amortization problem. A $450,000 mortgage loan financed at 2.8% compounded semi-annually requires month-end payments of $1,850. How many payments are required? To solve this, let's first set PY to 12, since payments are made monthly. And then we set CY to 2 for semi-annual compounding. Then press second quit. Next we input 2.8 IY for interest, 450,000 for present value, 1850, negative for payment since payment is an outflow. And then zero future value since we plan to pay off the mortgage at the end. And when we compute n, we obtain 358.53. That is, 359 payments are required. The size of the 359th payment, however, will be smaller than the previous payments of 1850. To find the principal repaid in the 10th payment, we press second amort, set P1 to 10. Enter, scroll down, we set P2 to 10 as well, enter, and when you scroll down, you see the outstanding balance after the 10th payment. You scroll down again, you see the principal repaid in the 10th payment, which is 823.06. Next, we want to calculate the total interest paid in the second year. Since payments are made monthly, the first year comprises of payments 1 to 12. The second year will comprise of the next 12 payments, which will be 13th to 24th. So we set P1 to 13, enter, scroll down and set P2 to 24, enter. Scroll down to interest and we have a total interest of 12,126.51 for the second year. Next, we want to calculate the outstanding balance at the end of the first 4 years. Since payments are made monthly, in 4 years we have 4 times 12, which equals 48 payments. So second amort, P1 can be any value less than 48, but we want to be sure we set P2 to 48, enter, and when we scroll down, we see that the balance is 409,122.15. To find the total interest paid in the first 5 years, we set P1 to 1 and scroll down and set P2 to 5 times 12, which equals 60. Enter, then scroll down to interest and we have 59,172.31. Next, we find the size of the final payment. Recall that n equals 358.53, so the final payment is the 359th payment. So we set P1 and P2 to 359. And we can see here that the outstanding balance is 870.25, which actually represents an overpayment if we make the regular payment of 1850. So to find the required last payment, we subtract the overpayment value of 870.25 from the regular payment of 1850 to obtain 979.75. So the size of the last payment is 979.75. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.